break. Now I know what it takes. I'm putting a new face on the old one, ready for anything. Playing with fate, not a moment too late. Showing the whole world.
You're home.
You better do your homework, Joey.
I don't have to do my homework. Aunt Nell's out shopping.
In other words, you think you can play checkers with me and avoid doing your homework. Well, you're not going to get away with it, young man. You're going to hit those books as soon as I get even.
Great. I'm ahead 6-2. King me. I'm home. Look at me. Nell, you went shopping.
I think your hat is adorable.
I didn't know it was the anniversary of Robin Hood's death.
Grandpa, for your information, I got this new hat because I have a very important job interview this afternoon. Thank you.
Well, if you're applying for the job of Sheriff of Nottingham, you're a cinch.
Samantha, would you help me fill out my application, please? Get a pen.
Why don't you just use your feather?
Hey, Nell, tell us about the job.
Oh, honey, it's perfect. The best thing about it is the hours. You see, I can still go to college at night, then I can do my new job, and I can still get home and have plenty of time to run everybody's life. I tell you, you people don't know how lucky you are.
So what's the new job, Aunt Nell?
Well, it's with the new electronics company in town. One of the executives needs a part-time secretary.
Aunt Nell, Does a part-time job mean you'll be gone in the afternoons?
Yeah, honey, but don't worry. Look, got it all figured out. I'll be home by 4, which means I'll be here at the house when you get out of school, and I'll be waiting for you to help you do your homework.
Can't you work till 6?
I was just kidding, Aunt Nell.
Hi, everybody.
Okay, Nell, I've got the pen. Let's fill out your application.
Are you applying for another credit card?
No, I'm applying for a job so I can pay for the one I got.
Yeah, Nell's going to be Sheriff of Nottingham.
Don't they vote for Sheriff?
So, Katie, how's everything at the new apartment, huh?
It's great, Grandpa. Except I never seem to have enough quarters for the washing machine. Could you just throw my laundry in with yours, Nell? I don't want to be any trouble, so just hit everything a few times with the iron.
I'm gonna hit you a few times with the iron.
Come on, Nell, let's fill out your application.
Okay, go ahead.
Name? Nellie Ruth Harper.
No. Just put down Nell Harper.
I'll get it.
Age?
30. Put it down.
Hi, everybody.
Hi.
Nell, why did you want to borrow my briefcase?
Oh, she's gonna be a secretary.
Excuse me, executive secretary, thank you.
For that new electronics company. See, we're filling out the application right now.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Thank you.
Nell, there's something missing.
What?
4 years off your age.
Oh, Addie, grow up. Nobody's gonna believe that I'm 34.
You got me, fool.
Look, why don't you tell me about the job? It sounds like it's perfect for you.
Oh, it is, Addie. Listen, best of all, I got all the skills, girl. I can type.
Yeah.
I can do a little shorthand. And best of all, I can run a home computer.
That's right. Plus, you've been running this household for years, and that takes organization and management.
Come on, now, let's finish your application.
Okay.
All right. Do you have a pleasing phone personality?
Ha.
What's your name?
Ha.
You ever talk to yourself on the phone?
Personality characteristics.
Okay. Put down easygoing, courteous, sunny disposition. You're not writing.
You have just described Robin Hood.
Now you need three character references.
That's easy. Put down Dr. Adelaide Wilson. You do it for me, what's
yes.
baby? All right. And put down Katie Kaniska. She has her own shop, and you better do it.
Okay.
Grandpapa, I don't like to ask you for anything, but could I please use you as a character reference?
Absolutely.
Thank you.
I have never met a character like you.
Nell, when's your interview?
My interview is in a half hour. I gotta go. I got to go.
Good. That gives you just enough time to buy a new hat.
This is my new hat.
And I love it.
Oh, no.
Well, I love that hat.
Get out of here.
No. What has become of your sunny disposition, Robin?
I am sunny, Robin. Give me my application. I'm gonna go down to that job and I'm gonna outshine every other applicant there. Because that's what employers like. They like self-confidence. Because when you have self-confidence in yourself, other people have confidence and self-confidence in you. And that's something I got plenty of, baby. I got self-confidence. Uh-huh. Yeah. I'm so scared.
Hi.
Do you need some help?
No, I'm here to see Mr. Randall.
Oh, okay, well, why don't you come on in his office? Wait for him in there.
Thank you.
He doesn't have a secretary yet.
Oh, well, that's why I'm here.
He should be along in a few minutes.
Thank you.
Good luck, huh?
Thank you. Hello. My name is Hell Knopper. Ms. Hopper here. Nell Hopper. Hello. Hopper. Nell Hopper, how do you do?
Randall.
Hi.
Forgive me for being late. Won't you sit down?
Yes.
So, you'd like to be my secretary?
Yes.
Well, do you have an application?
Yes. Well, as you can see, my application is all in order right there.
This is very impressive, young woman.
Why, thank you.
Do you have any experience answering telephones?
Oh, honey, I mean, sir. I run a household with three teenage girls. I tell you, can't ask for more telephone answering experience than that, and I can't hear.
A sense of humor, too.
Yes, uh-huh.
The job is mostly telephone. Pardon. Yes. No, I'll come right out. Will you excuse me? This won't take a second.
Well, just remember, I'm easygoing and I'm courteous and I have a sunny disposition.
Thank you.
Hello? Mr. Randall's office? I'm sorry, Mr. Randall just stepped out, but I'm sure he'll be back in a few moments. You want me to take a message? Okay, well, wait a minute. Okay, what's your name? Wait a minute. Hold on. Oh. Mr. Levitt, okay. B&V Industries, right. You want to confirm? Okay, hold on, one minute. Yes, he has you down for 12:30 luncheon at the country club. Yes, thank you. You have a nice day. Okay, bye-bye.
You did that very well.
Thank you. Well, the difficult we do immediately, the impossible just takes a little bit longer.
I love your sense of humor. And you know, I admire your initiative. The way you picked up that phone without anybody telling you. I can see that on top of everything else, you're a self-starter. And that's a quality I admire.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming in.
Oh, my sense of humor.
This is the best interview I've had all day.
Thank you. Well, what time do you want me to start tomorrow?
You're just not the person I'm looking for. Goodbye.
Is a bigot.
Nell, what are you saying?
I'm saying the man is a bigot and a racist. He came right out and said that he was impressed with my application and that he admired my initiative. Then he turned right around and he said I wasn't what he was looking for. Well, I guess we all know what that means, don't we?
It means he isn't hiring blacks.
I am appalled. Of the police department don't condone this sort of behavior. As a matter of fact, 12.5% of all our police patients are black. That's 0.5% above the norm. And we have 2.5 Hispanic Latinos.
That's impressive, 2.5%.
No, we got 2.5 people. You have forgotten our head meter maid, Officer Rosita Ginsburg. She's Jewish, Hispanic, and a woman. She does it all.
Simpson, somewhere here in Glen Lawn, there is a crime being committed. Be there.
I'm off duty till 4:00.
All right. What are we going to do about this bigot?
It's hard to believe there's still prejudice against minorities.
There's no prejudice against minorities in Glen Lawn. We have 4 Chinese restaurants.
Katie, we're talking prejudice here. We're not talking takeout.
Nell, I'll try to put this as delicately as possible. So here goes. Are you sure you didn't open that great big mouth of yours and blow it?
No, Grandpapa, I'm saving my great big mouth for you.
I wouldn't save it. There's plenty to go around for it.
You lucky you old.
Nell?
What?
Well, I have a friend on the Fair Employment Commission, but the first thing he'll ask for is more proof.
That's wonderful. And just how am I supposed to get that?
Well, one way is to get someone else to apply for the job and see if he turns them down, too.
I'll go. Katie, you're not black.
Darn.
Hey, Ed, are you kind of black?
You know, if he turns down someone like Addie, that'll be the proof.
Right, and Addie's really qualified, Nell.
Oh, and she's highly sophisticated, Nell.
And Addie's got a PhD, huh, Nell?
And Addie's got a Phi Beta Kappa key. She's highly intelligent, Nell.
Oh, yes, yes, yes. She ain't not no ignorant, unsophisticated.
sophisticated Nanny Ruth Harper. Well, I guess I'll just shuffle on down. You want some possum?
We're trying to help, Nell.
Look, Nell, if you don't want me to do it, I won't.
Granny, it's just... they made me jealous.
Oh, Nell, you shouldn't be jealous. That job is perfect for you.
Thank you, Addie.
I'm overqualified.
Overqualified?
No, what I meant was...
Well, that's okay, babe. Yes, you're overqualified. And you also overbearing. You are overconfident, and you are over the hill. Oh. And you're underdeveloped.
So now you hate Mr. Randall?
No, honey, I don't hate Mr. Randall, even though he is a racist. No, honey, no one should ever hate anybody, you know? That's why when we go to church Sunday, I'm going to pray for one.
You are?
Mm-hmm. And if my prayers are answered, God help him.
Nell, if Mr. Randall's against black people, why did Addie go for the job?
Well, see, honey, if he turns Addie down for the job, then we will have positive proof that he is prejudiced against black people.
Aunt Nell?
What, honey?
What if he gives Addie the job he wouldn't give you? Would that make you mad?
Of course not. No, honey. It would, first of all, would prove that that nice man is not a bigot. It would also prove that they're in this wonderful town that was just free of prejudice and racism. Tell you the truth, I really hope Addie gets the job.
He didn't give me the job.
Wonderful! I knew he's a bigot. He's a bigot. He's a bigot.
Oh, get a grip on yourself, girl. Do you know that Randall did the same thing to me that he did to you? He told me I was qualified, and then he told me to get out.
Listen, why don't we go back downtown, get a hungry German shepherd, and go over to his office?
Well, I already called my friend from the Fair Employment Office, and he's meeting us at Randall's office in a half hour.
That's good. Wait a minute. Joey, we're going out for a while.
I told you. Will you relax? Will you relax?
Benjamin?
Oh.
Hi. Thank you so much for meeting us down.
Oh, I'm glad to, Addie.
Nell, this is Benjamin Guthrie.
How do you do?
How do you do? Look, are you going to be able to nail this guy? You want me to go get a dog?
Oh, I don't think that'll be necessary.
Oh, yes, it is, honey, because I want him. I want you to get that man. I want to get him. I want to get him. I want to get him.
Of course we'll get him. We can't permit that kind of behavior. I've been fighting it for 40 years.
That's right. You know, Benjamin marched 20 miles in the march on Selma and 50 miles in the march on Washington.
I marched and I'm tired.
He's only 20 feet to his door, and you'll make it.
You know, I see this as a test case for the movement. Now, it's important that our people and that whole rainbow of minorities are not blocked from any job. From the switchboard to the chairman of the board. From the executive secretary to the executive office. From the outhouse to the White House.
Jesse, didn't you?
Yes, ma'am. Here
yes, I want that man. I want him. I want that man. You should have brought a dog.
Mr. Randall, I'm Benjamin Guthrie from the Fair Employment Office.
How do you do?
And we're here to register a formal complaint about your hiring practices.
Well, what seems to be the problem?
Well, Nell and I applied today for a job as your assistant, and you turned both of us down.
That's correct.
You did tell me that I was qualified, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
And I happen to have a Ph.D.
Show him your Phi Beta Kappa Key
girl. No, I
it won't be necessary.
Oh, yes, it is. Start marching, Benjamin. Tell this man how you've been marching for over 40 years, from the outhouse to the White House. Will there be some kind of fools? We know what's going on in here.
Excuse me, Mr. Randall, but you asked to see these contracts as soon as they came in?
Thank you, Michael.
Who is that?
Well, that's my new secretary. I just hired him.
But he's black.
Have you got something against black people?
One moment, please. What about that?
Oh, it's a trick.
That's right. They obviously hired one token to try to throw us off the track.
Oh. Hi, Phil.
Hi, Bob.
Just wanted to say, we got the engineering problem licked.
Thank you, Bob.
He's a plant. That man is a plant. You knew we were coming over here, so you went and hired them.
Say, Phil.
Get out of here, plant!
Now, look. Nobody treats my employees like that. Now, you get out.
Mr. Randall, these ladies told me you were against hiring black people.
Me? Me against black people? A man who marched on Washington?
You were in the march?
Yes.
Well, I was on bus 14.
Get out. I was on bus 9. God, that felt good. I haven't done that since 63. Why are you down here calling me a bigot, Ben?
Well, it wasn't my idea, Phil.
Phil, wait a minute. Wait. You gotta look at it from my point of view.
From both our
points of view,
Phil.
I mean,
Hold it!
Yes, Phil.
I will not stand here and justify myself to two hysterical females. And people wonder why I won't work with women.
So it's not our color. You just don't hire women.
That's not true. You come around here after 6 o'clock, and you'll see plenty of women working with mops and pails.
Oh, you are not going to get away with this. Mr. Guthrie is going to go to his office tomorrow, and he's going to file a report against you.
I'm not going in tomorrow. Today was my last day. I retired this morning. I got my watch and everything.
Retired? Nonsense. You're too young to retire. I could use a good man like you, Ben.
Really?
Well, yes. Phil? Come and have dinner with me, and we'll talk about it. Where in the world did you find these harpies?
The dogs. Get the dogs.
No, forget about it, Nell. We don't need Guthrie. We'll take this to the Congress of Determined Women, and they'll take Randall to court. Look, we really have a case of prejudicial policy against hiring women.
Get it, please. It just takes months, and I want the man. I want him now. Hello, Mr. Randall's office.
Oh, hello, Mrs. Randall. I'm sorry Mr. Randall stepped out. You see, a young woman applicant got hysterical when he turned her down for a job, so he had to go over to her apartment to calm her down. And he told me that if you called to tell you not to wait up, because he would be home late. Bye-bye.
Yeah. Oh, Addie, I think that's wonderful. So you mean the city is actually going to take Mr. Randall to court?
Aunt
Nell? One minute, honey. That'll teach his butt not to hire women, won't it? Well, girl, I told you I wanted the man, and I got him. Okay, I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye. What?
Aunt Nell?
What?
I don't understand. Why doesn't that guy hire women?
Well, because he's a male chauvinist.
What's that?
Well, honey, a male chauvinist is a man who thinks that women are dumber, weaker, and can't do anything as well as a man can.
Gee, thanks, Aunt Nell. I really learned something today.
That's good, honey.
Hey, Sam, guess what? I just found out I'm a male chauvinist.